I will never work in broadcasting again. And on that bombshell.
At number 8, it's Tears Before Bedtime as the world says goodbye to a Scottish doctor without a name.
What could you want more on Christmas Day than to sit around with all the family and watch an excellently made, brilliant entertainment show about a guy who can go anywhere in time and space and have these most wonderful adventures?
I saw the phosphorus carousel of the great Magellan Gestapo. Saved a planet from the red carnivorous maw. Named the galaxy Allison.
I don't really know the reason for the success of Doctor Who at Christmas, except that they do spend money on it, and it does become an epic rather than just an episode. And it is more or less like a feature film, you know.
David Tennant's Doctor had really captured the heart of the nation, actually. He was absolutely loved, and so it was a joy for me to see that era of television history, actually, brought to an end in such spectacular style.
Better be quick. 3, 2, 1.
And it was just beautifully crafted by Russell T Davies. The fact that the Doctor had his chance to go back and see all of his friends and bid them farewell.
Tell you what, I bet you're going to have a really great year.
Yeah? See ya.
With this Doctor, probably more than any before, it really felt like he was dying.
I don't want to go.
I said, you know, what are you going to do with that? And he said, I don't know. I don't know yet. And he really didn't know. I mean, there are so many ways you could have said it, you know. I think it worked very well.
Quite right that it was so epic and so huge, because actually you were seeing one of the most popular characters on British television take his final bow.
We all felt when he went that sort of emotion that he seemed to feel, or the character seemed to feel, I don't want to go. And then within 10 minutes of the Matt Smith episode, we were going, oh, Matt Smith is great. Who, David who?
With their third appearance tonight, it's Morecambe and Wise with a classic.